for the top 10 best Fortnite Battle Royale players in the scene.
Patrick here, and hey, so I really am kind of sad to lose my streak on making positive Fortnite videos, but we need to talk. The guided rocket sucks. I can't think of something that they have put into Fortnite that I like less than the guided rocket. And I really wasn't going to make this video. It's been a week since it came out. You haven't seen anything from me. But today is the day. Fortnite released a version 2 of the explosives only game mode, and guess what? The guided rocket is in it. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be looking at 5 reasons the guided rocket sucks, and more specifically, why it ruins explosives only mode. Now, as always, if you're new to the channel, please feel free to subscribe. If you're already subscribed, hit that like button. But ladies and gentlemen, here we go. So this list is going to be in no particular order, but coming in at number 5, on our list is the fact that it encourages camping. The reason that Fortnite is so fun is because it's a game that you can run out in the open and just have a really good time. You know, as soon as someone starts shooting at you, you can build, you can always find cover, and that makes Fortnite great to me. Long-term camping in Fortnite is like the stupidest thing ever, and that's exactly what this thing makes you do. I mean, the gameplay up on screen right now is probably me just sitting in a building, firing rocket after rocket after rocket at just really bad players. And that's what I hate about it. You're literally just sitting tucked away in a building, all safe and cuddly, just firing this death rocket. It's not fair to other players that are actually running around playing the game like, in my opinion, it should be played, and instead you're not even being a noob, but I just think anything that encourages camping in Fortnite is a bad thing. And let me tell you, this certainly does. Okay, now moving down to our number 4 spot, this is going to be skill. The things in my mind that stand out about good Fortnite items are always the things that take skill to use. The thing that really comes to mind when I talk about this is impulse grenades. They're something that are kind of good if you don't know how to use them, but if you can use them, you will absolutely devastate people. That being said, the guided rocket is a very low skill weapon. It doesn't really matter if you're me or ninja. I mean, basically it goes the same speed, and besides being able to maneuver, it really is no different. But the thing is it's an item that takes little skill to use, is very good, and is completely RNG dependent. There's a very low percentage chance of getting this thing, but if you get it, it's just like this absolute huge reward that you really did nothing to earn. And furthermore, the problem with this being such a powerful item that is yet unskillful is the counter to it is extremely skillful. What I mean by that is if you want to actually kill someone that's just firing rocket after rocket after rocket at you, you gotta be a really good player. And in my opinion, it just shouldn't be that way. It doesn't feel balanced and it doesn't feel fair. So those are 2 points that aren't specifically guided at explosives only. They're kind of general for Fortnite. But now I wanna look at 3 things that are actually just only pertaining to explosives only. So I can already see the comments saying this thing is not overpowered for a few reasons. The first reason being, all you have to do is box yourself in and they can't kill you. And yeah, in solos, that's true. The counter to this thing is the rocket comes at you, you start building, and then as they are basically reshooting it, you continue your build. As soon as it gets close, you build up again, and you push to them until you got them, and then you kill them. But again, jumping back to our number 4 point, that takes a lot of skill. Well, even if you have a ton of skill in duos or squads, good luck trying to counter this, because you're going to have, bar none, one guided rocket coming at you while you've got 3 other RPGs all coming at you from different angles. And even if they're coming at you from the same angle, that guided rocket might be coming up behind you. But now let's take a scenario where you've got 2 guided rockets, 3, maybe even 4 coming at you. How do you counter that? Even if you've got a full squad sending RPGs at them, that is something that is very, very difficult to counter. So while I could kind of see that the argument of boxing in solos does work, as soon as you go over to squads and explosives only, it's just not possible. And this brings me to my number two point, which is a counter to what everybody says. It's not that overpowered because not only can you box yourself in, you can shoot it down. Have you ever tried shooting a rocket with a rocket? Let alone you don't have a rocket and all you've got is eggs. Bunny butt eggs at that. No, in explosives only, you don't even have the second counter to the guided rocket, which is to shoot it. The only way that you can counter this thing is with building. And in squads, that is near impossible. And that basically brings me down to my number one point, is that people will argue that in solos, it's not that overpowered. And I just think that that is a terrible argument. I'm gonna read a comment that I saw on Reddit that sums up the guided rocket perfectly, in my opinion. This comment comes from IWN, who says, yeah, you can box yourself in or shoot it down, and then what? Just wait for the rockets to run out? In solos, it might be fine, but trust me, this thing is completely broken in duos and squads. Box yourself in, you have one guy shooting down with AR, or in explosives only, rockets, and the other guy has the missile. You can't run out to push because of the rockets and AR fire, and in explosives only, more RPGs, and you can't even run out to push because of the rockets and the AR fire. Furthermore, you can't even just wait for them to run out because they have 30 plus rockets and you've got a storm coming, slash might run out of materials. And that is basically, in a nutshell, my argument as to why I don't like this thing. But to go even further, in explosives, rather than maybe at the max this person has 30 rockets, no, in explosives only, you're gonna be rocking 150 of these things. You're never going to run out. It's an infinitely broken concept, even if both teams have them. Because at the end of the day, let's say every single player in a 4v4 has it. Well, is that even fun? It's just remote control battles? Like, that is not Fortnite. It barely works in normal Fortnite and is an absolute mess in explosives only. But that being said, I did promise you five whole fixes to the guided rocket. So the first thing that I would propose to fix this is actually just give it different ammo. If you only had like 5 to 10 of these things max in a game, that wouldn't be so broken. If you actually had to be conservative with these things and use them at the right time, I'd be okay with that. But the fact that it's the same as the RPG is just absolutely ridiculous. If every single person has 180 of these things, like, what do you do? What do you do? So I think it would actually make a lot of sense if they just gave it different ammo. Easy solution. But I've actually got 4 more of these stellar ideas. This one is really simple, but just make it do less damage. I think it's pretty ridiculous that this thing does as much damage as an RPG. An RPG, you actually have to build, maneuver yourself in a position where you're not going to hurt you, but you're gonna kill the other guy. That takes skill. And the fact that the damage value of that thing is equal to the guided missile is just ridiculous. Now, let's say this maybe did 75 damage or even 50, I think it would be a lot more balanced. Now, my next idea is a little bit weird, but I think that this would be kind of cool, is that you can't disconnect. There's not even a commitment to using it. You know, you can fire it and, oh, someone's coming up on me, disconnect, and that's it. Well, what if they made it so that as soon as you fire this thing, you are committed until the timer runs out or it blows up? This would make players a little bit more thoughtful when they use it, as they can't just use it whenever they want, and, you know, there's no commitment to it. And I think that that could potentially do a lot for it. It's not my favorite idea, and I honestly think that maybe a combination of different ammo and lowering the damage would be best, but it would at least help. Now, my next idea is really out there and it's really different, but I think it is cool. My favorite feature of this thing is the fact that you can shoot it up in the sky and just look around for where enemies are. So what if they made this a new item where it's basically just a recon drone? You shoot it out into the sky, it can't kill anybody, it can be shot down, and you can actually just go and look for other enemies. Awesome. It would actually encourage gunfights, it would reduce camping like this thing does encourage, and I think that would be a huge fix for it. Not even necessarily a fix, but like a, hey, we kind of messed up on this thing, but here's what we got out of it. Oh, and my last point is pretty simple. It's the one that I'm rooting for personally. Just remove it. It's such a rare thing to encounter in Fortnite, and it just, it to me, whenever I do run into someone with one of these, it feels foreign. It doesn't feel like Fortnite. It feels like this weird thing that just, it shouldn't be in the game. At the end of the day, I really think that they should just completely scrap this idea, or maybe turn it into a recon plane. Besides rocket riding, I just don't understand how any player can be like, yeah, this is a really fun thing. Just cruising a rocket around, looking for someone and gumming down on them and killing them. It can absolutely be outplayed, but as soon as you get into the squads and even duos, it becomes a pretty challenging thing to do. And at the end of the day, it just encourages camping and takes no skill to use. So while I don't hate it in regular Fortnite, because I really don't see it that much, I don't think it has a place in explosives only. I know it's an LTM, they're not gonna remove it, but I don't like it. Anyways though, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. I gotta say, explosives only is a really good time. I'm absolutely loving it. I never got to play the original version, so it's awesome to finally experience this. That being said, I've just really not been a fan of the guided rockets when I use it or when someone else is using it, so that's kind of where I stand. Other than that, I will talk to you guys later. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out, you freaking athletes. Doesn't have the same ring.